I have two separate control panels for this unit. This is the Clough42 control panel that allows me to thread and do auto feed based on how fast the spindle is moving. But I also added this, which is a basic stepper motor controller that independently of the Clough42 system allows me to use the stepper motor as a power feed.
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video. So here's the problem with this configuration. You can take and drill a hole into a plate or a box and mount the potentiometer into that hole and secure the entire thing. But then 90 degrees of that, you have the push buttons. And that just makes it hard to mount and hard to use. This is the switch that I will be using to replace the switches on the board. It is a double pull, double throw toggle switch. The important thing to know is the way that it's set up. You have two center posts that are common, and when the switch is thrown one way, it will send the signal there and there, and when it's thrown the other way, it'll send the signal there and there. This switch is set up a little different than the toggle switches that I'm going to be using. It's push button, and the commons are this outside one and this outside one. So when I push the push button, it'll send a signal from here to here, and it'll send a signal from there to there. Then when you push the button again, the signal then goes from this common to the middle and from that common to the middle. It's very important to make sure that everything is wired the same way. And since the double pull, double throw switches are configured slightly different, not correctly hooking it up will cause problems. So the first issue we have to deal with is how do you get these switches off? I've already removed this one. When removing a component from a board, the easiest way to typically do it is to sever the connection between the component and the board, completely removing the component, and then you can heat each individual terminal and use a pair of pliers to pull it out. Sadly, that's not an option with this because this switch is solid up against the board, so there's no way for me to get a cutting tool in there. The technique I'm going to go with is what I like to call the heat and pull. I hold the board and I have my finger on the component putting side loading pressure on it. Then I simply melt the solder. Both connections. There we go. We got liquid there, and we go back and forth. Applying heat. Did you see that pop right out? It's completely loose on that end. Now we do the same thing in reverse. We heat the solder connection, put a little pressure, apply a little heat, try and get it on all of the connections. All right, we are almost completely loose. We got just a little bit more holding it on this other side. Sometimes at this point, you don't have quite enough angle to easily be able to put pressure on it and pull it off. So, yep, there we go, it's off. The component's out, but some of the holes are still filled with solder, and that's gonna make soldering a new connection to them challenging. So how do we get that solder out? I found the easiest technique is to take a steel pick, just like this one, and place it in where the hole should be. Kind of hard to do on camera here. And then heat the solder on the back side, pushing the pin through. You can see that sticking through just like that. Once you do that, the solder will not stick to the pick, and so you can pull it out and you have the hole. I'll go ahead and do the other ones and then wire some wires up to it. So here it is, all wired up. I now have the freedom to mount it the way I want to. I can, again, like I would have before, drill a hole into a box or plate and mount the potentiometer, and then I can drill two adjacent holes to mount the toggle switches. And that will allow me to easily mount the unit and use it. The last piece of the puzzle is this switch right here. This is a double pull, quadruple throw. So in other words, if there's a signal coming into here and you switch it one way, it's going to go here. If you switch it the other way, it's going to go here. And the same is true all the way up. So this one to this one and so on. And that's what allows me to switch between my ELS driving my stepper motor and this simple handheld control driving my stepper motor.
Main control box has all the electronics. You've got the stepper motor controller. You've got the main brains of the operation, the board, and then the Clough42 board. This switch right here gives me, this is for threading when it's down. When it's up, it's going with the power feed.
So here's my temporary power feed control setup. Eventually, I am going to replace this bracket with an actual box so that the board that's underneath is completely enclosed. Also, I have ordered some 6-connection wire, so it'll be one wire with 6 connections rather than this handful of individually stranded wire. How it works is pretty simple. We have the main power. This is my switch. It's currently set up in the threading with the Clough42 setup. We put it in the up position to go from Clough42 to this being the control. This is on off, so that's on. And this right here is the direction. So if I push it this way, it's going to push the carriage that direction. If I push it that way, it's going to push the carriage that direction. Turn it on. Adjust the speed a little bit. Engage the clutch. Carriage is moving. We go the other direction. Disengage the clutch at any point, switch directions, turn it on, turn it off, anything that you need to do. Engage the clutch again and away we go. Very happy with how this works.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.
So this is the switch that I'm... My hands are all dirty. What the? The easiest technique I've found is you take a steel... How about if I put the thing in the frame? The holes are out, but now some of the... The holes are out? Really? That's what I said?